gnome's raunchy as fuck.
Okay, cool. So what's the plan? Where are you going? Back into the ground fields. I'll bring the list back up. So,
should we head like south, but still along the edge of the forest?
Is there anything in particular you guys want to hunt? So, giant vulture is on the list in the little tier, but it would only be enough to get one of you in.
Yeah.
I definitely think a giant boar is the best way to go.
Yeah, I think
boars are easy to trap, pretty dumb, and huge.
It's gotta be top tier.
Are you the type of gnome that has resistance to poison? No, that was a stout half.
Yeah, I don't think so. Mm-hmm. I've never been poisoned, but
I was just thinking if we can get some giant spider fangs and make some poison weapons, that'll help out taking some.
So it works on like a sliding scale, right? To get all its one thing on the middle tier would get you one of you in come three of a decent space. So if you had one thing from the middle tier each, then you're all in for something.
Yeah,
and something from the top tier would probably be enough to help all of you. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Do we literally just want to pass the flying? Is that what we want to do, or do we want to pass the flying?
Flying colors.
So then let's work our way up. Let's start killing some stuff that's lower down, and then.
So I like your idea. If we kill a giant spider, get some poison, which we can use that for a giant boar. Because I think of the top tier, that's the easiest to take down. Because the two dinosaurs is literally suicide.
Yeah.
A griffin's too hard to ensure that you kill it before it just flies away. Fuck snakes. Just straight up fuck snakes. And the saber-toothed tiger is way too sneaky.
Yeah.
Giant boars are dumb, loud, and huge.
Yeah.
Also, the wolves and hyenas, they will be in packs.
Yeah.
It might be able to get a tiger on its own.
Maybe, but
a saber-tooth tiger would be a bit tricky.
Yeah, I don't think we need a tiger. I think we want to aim for the spider just to get the poison, and then we can take on the top tier, the boar. And that, if we get one boar, it's enough for all of us.
Yeah.
We're not going to get that anytime soon. We are still level.
Yeah, we probably also want to set out some, like get some decent armor.
Yeah.
But again, if we kill the spider, we can make armor out of spider hide.
Spice hot.
We basically need a training montage.
Yeah. Gonna need a montage.
Are we gonna go straight for the giant spider?
I'd say go to the bus table first.
Got what?
What's down on the bus table?
So what we can harvest.
We've already killed a vulture.
Yeah, we took out a vulture pretty easily.
We're not messing with giant goats.
I remember what happened last time we messed with a giant goat. My character would be triggered. Just say that much. It's what killed Dave's first character.
I think Crocodile would be really good to get some armor first.
Yes.
Because their skin is tough to shit.
And it's really easy to.
Is Crocodile in puss tier or middle tier?
It's the top of puss tier.
Okay. Oh, it is, okay.
It's always ascending, so if you kill a hippogriff, it's still better than killing a dire wolf, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yeah, so they're ascending through the tiers. So hippogriff is the best thing on middle tier.
I see. So that dinosaur is like the top of the top. Like you're an absolute beast if you kill one of those.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
I am efficient.
I vote we kill a giant goat.
What?
Let's go for crocodile.
Let's get a couple of crocodiles if we can. And then that'll be enough for.
I guess we will.
Yeah.
Okay.
So that'll be hide armor, I guess.
Yeah.
Hide armor. Which would be 13 plus dex. Better for me. So
yeah.
I think it's just a case of getting. We'll find more things.
Oh, we've got tons of feathers, so I can start using a bow pretty soon.
Yeah.
Some arrows.
Okay, so if you're wanting to hunt crocodiles, there's a region just to the south of you, where you are now. I've drawn this on this map, but just here, where the forest, this sort of central block here, where it's half forest, half gravel fields. It's a region referred to as the Talbar. Basically, this is where, as well as there being forest, and it's probably the greenest part of the gravel fields. This is also where water runs down from the rise, so there's pools and small rivers. So this is generally where life is concentrated in the gravel fields. Generally, you would avoid it because where there's water, there's prey. Where there's prey, there's predators.
Yeah.
If you're wanting to hunt crocodiles, then you would need to go down into the Talbar.
Let's do it.
Yeah, have to be quiet.
Head down that way.
I'm good at that. Yes, you are, brother.
Yeah, so the Talbar would be just here. So you can either head south along, you head south through the gravel fields, or you can try and cut through the woods to get there.
Mm-hmm.
You've got a choice of two different terrains while you're in the town, or you can walk along the border.
Okay.
And the worst of both worlds.
Woods is going to be like less aggressive things in there if we get
them, yeah.
Plus coverage from the sky.
Let's stay in the forest and head back.
Okay, cool. Yeah, perfectly fine. So, somebody roll a d20 and then see how our walk in the woods goes.
Good God, not me.
Five, okay. So yeah, roll a... Somebody, who's going to be leading the way as well? Who's taking you down there?
Gosh.
Who's navigating you? I'll be fine, thank you.
One of the armory people.
Yeah.
Well, we're doing a bit of a job, so...
So you're navigating, so roll some over for me. We'll see how well you can get down there.
Well, I don't think you can charge.
Five. Okay, so yeah, it you can get there because you're just heading south, but it's a long way. So by the time the day's finished, you are still in the woods. You'd make it to... one sec. Around here, and by the time night falls. So yeah, you're not down at the tower bar yet, you're still in the woods on that day. So yeah, you spend a long day tramping through the forest. Can somebody roll a d20 to see how bad the weather is?
Six,
okay, pretty shitty. So yeah, I'd say as the day goes past, the day is very sort of cold and over clouds. So you look up through the top of the pine trees, and you get a small window of sky directly above you, and that's rarely goes above very dark grey. So by the time the evening falls around, it gets very cold.
I'm safe in my feathers, right?
Yeah, you would be fine. But yeah, tonight sleeping, you're going to need a fire, at the least, or some means of keeping yourself warm.
Well, can I the best we don't go to the tower on that just yet?
Can I spend my time looking around again for like shelter, cave, and
yes,
like that?
100%, yeah, go for it.
Gigantic trees that shelter us from everything.
Okay. So yeah, you manage to find a relatively decent spot. You don't find... I'd say you find a shallow cave. So it's sort of on a hill. There's a hillside that you make your way a little ways up. And there's just a portion where as the hill continues to go up, there's a small incline which goes down into the side of the hill. It doesn't go far. It looks like it's been dug out by something that left it a long time ago. There's cobwebs and all sorts inside here. And there's the very faint smell of some sort of sweaty animal, but it seems whatever was in here is long gone. It's not enough that you'd be able to conceal a fire, but you'll be kept in out of the cold. The worst of it anyway.
And the fire won't be rained on.
And the fire won't be rained on, I say.
Okay, well I guess we're getting to building a fire then.
Mm. Yep.
Okay.
Good spot.
Sweet. So you guys make a fire. Are you gonna? So you've already eaten today. You're gonna. You've already had food today, so you don't need to eat again. You're still in the woods, so you can get water as well. So that's fine.
Well, we probably want to keep the rations and just scavenge food today.
Mm-hmm.
Because if we spend a day out on the gravel fields, then we're gonna want to eat while we're out there.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine. Yeah. So yeah, you. You can continue to ride through and run. So what sleeping arrangement is going to be? You could all fit into the cave, but you won't be able to see out. Other than in one direction down the hill, you'll be able to see.
I suppose now
that
we're
all
exhausted,
we'll
have to look out, take
shifts. Okay. Sweet. How the ship's going to go? So it's already getting dark, so everybody's got dark vision anyway, to a certain extent.
Yeah.
But you've got different levels of dark vision. The dwarf's got better dark vision, haven't you?
Yeah.
Is it not?
It's a standard 60, and then it's Drow, Deep Gnomes,
Droger,
yeah.
Oh, okay.
Ones that have the 120 foot.
Okay, sweet, that's fine. So yeah, what order are the watches going to go in then?
I'll take the midnight shift.
Good night.
I'll go for...
Matt, me, then
run, and then
So hold on. So
can I just start like while I'm on watch, just start weaving some rope?
Yeah, you can do that again. So yeah, roll a survival check for me.
Rope is useful for everything, especially nets. Ooh, I'm gonna use my inspiration for that. That's one. That is an 18.
18, nice. So your last time you got 18, it was 4, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So yeah, you can have four loads. Four. Is it? You want a length of rope this time, or you want any more stuff you're making things out of?
Is there anything? I want to reinforce my staff so it won't break.
Okay, so yeah, if you want to use it for that sort of stuff, then yeah, you've got four lots of twine basically for cutting things. What else do we need?
I'm gonna spend my watch to try and make some axe.
Okay. And that's gonna be the same sort of things that you're just gonna make out of like twine. Roll the survival check up for me then. Oh, that's a D12.
Thank you. 17.
Nice. Yeah, we'll say 3 lots of it for 17, and just below. So yeah, you've got 3 lots of twine that you can make something out of each.
Yeah, I'll make all packs out of that.
Okay, so yeah, 3.
I'll make you a bow, one of my ones.
Okay, so yes, you can make 3 simple packs. So like when I say packs, they are literally just twine tied in such a way that you can tie it around your arms, and then you can tie other things to it. Mm-hmm. So yeah, your sacks are basically a twine cape you can then tie things into, like it's Nux beard.
Yeah.
Cool, that's fine.
So yeah, can I make him a bow?
Yes, roll survival point, you'll see how big it is.
Yeah, man.
Grit.
Ooh, crit.
Crit, okay, so yeah, you can make a fully working bow.
Yeah.
Like that. It would just be a short bow, I'm assuming.
No,
will
you even have proficiency for maybe?
Not long ago, a short bow.
You go with short bow, yeah, so short bow.
Yeah, it would have short bow and white cross.
Okay, cool.
And
so yeah,
then, can I use the other two to make nets?
Yes.
Crazy. Yeah. So I have 2 nets.
Cool. Yeah, that's perfectly fine. What are the dragons doing with your knight?
Help it out. Origin. Don't know what I can do really. Make some shards. You could try and make yourself a shield. Yeah. I'll take Gracie up by 2. But then 6. Yeah. Just bark.
Yeah, you could make a very weak bark shield. You find something about it. I'd say it would only give you +1 instead of +2 if you can make it out of bark. But you can make some rudimentary shields.
Yeah. I'll do that.
Please.
Okay, cool. Roll survival up for me then.
That's not bad. That's
14.
Fletcher.
Making some arrows.
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Have you already got a shield?
I will want it. If you can make 2, then that's great.
Can I make 2?
Well, you tried.
What was your survival check? What did you get?
14.
14.
Dude.
Yeah, no, I'd say you can just make 1 with 14, based on what I've been doing previously.
Alright.
Who's going to take the shield?
Who needs it most? I got 14 now, but
I'm also 14.
I wouldn't mind taking it temporarily until we level up, and then I can give it back.
I
trade it with you for my main spot.
Yeah, so I give you the main spot. Yeah, that's fine. So yeah, it's +1 because it's just a rudimentary shield.
Okay, I'll be up to 13.
And it's made of bark, so it may break if something big enough chomps onto it or slashes into it. But yeah, it's enough to give you 1 AC for the time being. And then what did you roll, sorry? 3, okay, so yeah, now unfortunately you're not able to cobble together anything enough that you can...
Your arrows are bent.
Yeah. Yeah,
you
like
just make a bunch
bolt.
Of boomerangs. Woo! Fire these from your bow.
What was the watch order again? And we're just going to keep this watch order for the...
Yeah.
So, Yara, and followed by... Who is second?
None.
Nook.
Sorry, yeah.
And then, who's going to run and jump in? Cool. Sweet, so can somebody roll a d20 for me?
Not me.
No.
18.
Nice,
Steve!
I like it.
Oh, God damn it, sir!
Fine, we've got some stuff now.
Not
enough!
Not very
much. Damage
stone!
18. So can I get...
18
stubble.
I'm happy now.
Oh, yeah. I love it. Can I get... Can you roll 3 of any dice? And let me know if the results are odd or even.
Odd, even.
Okay, cool. Can I get... 2d8, please? So 5 and an 8 on the d8, so that's
13,
yeah, as I say.
5 and
8,
yeah.
Okay, yeah. And again,
it,
same
thing.
Don't
like that.
Same thing again.
Oh,
2d8. Yeah, 2d8, please.
Oh, look at that machine.
That's
there.
A 6. 1,
7.
7.
Oh, perfect. That's exactly what I wanted. And...
It's like a... What are you doing? With a huge... Oh, it's a three-wheeled bike.
Tricycle.
Yep.
Can I get... and now 2d6, please. 4.
1.
5. 5, and you're in the middle words.
I can
okay.
add lots of things.
There we go. Oh, God, just
yeah,
that
very messy.
Here it is. I'm going to pop for a quick piss break while I ponder what this is.
Well, guys, it's nice, don't you?
Good lineup. This is like the fifth time you said that, eh?
So who's watches this happening again?
Yours,
I guess. Oh, Lord, yeah. But
I'm gonna
at least it's right at the start,
back.
So I'll get any spells I use back.
Yeah.
Who's not using, because your thing's two-handed.
I'm gonna place one-handed. That's the
mace is one-handed.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna give you the shield back, because I just realised I'm using a two-handed staff.
Okay.
Shield damage. To do any decent damage at all.
Sweet.
So you're up to 15.
I'm invincible.
Whatever's about to happen, bring it on.
Just famous last words.
Prepare to dodge.
Dodge! Why didn't you dodge? Do we know those cultists? One of them was burned. I feel like that was important, but I don't remember torching any cultists.
I don't think so. Not yet. There's still time, because we're still at the point where we didn't really stop unleashing that evil monstrous thing from the measure.
I'm ready for it all to come together and like...
Just another crossover.
The main Ocker's group meets up with the guys from the college, and they run into the monks.
But this one's based in the future, because he said that the library hasn't been accessible for some time.
Well, I mean...
That means something to you guys.
Yeah.
Oh,
so
I'm missing so much canon.
We previously went through a library where there was basically this magical guard dog.
We woke it up.
Made enough noise in the library, we'd wake up and kill everyone. So we stealthed our way all the way through, and then just as we like got through the door on the other side, I grabbed a book and just lobbed it into the front. Slammed the door closed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Also, this is a magical place where when you close the door, it doesn't open to the exact same spot anymore. So to find the library, you have to be lucky, and then you open the door, and that fucking beast is awake.
So that dog's just purring awake now.
Yeah, or
I don't
just
know. Yeah, woke it up anyway.
I'm just ready for it all to come together, and it's all of our groups against the cult of Sprax and those two wraiths.
I'm just waiting till we have to get out of the tower.
Yeah,
probably have to go through the library.
Mm-hmm.
Oh no.
So can
why did you wake it up? Like,
can I get a D4?
Because
yeah.
Three.
Okay, sweet. So you guys set up camp inside this little hole. I'm with each of you taking a turn to sit just outside the mouth of the cave and keep lookout. I'd say, so run. This happens during your watch. You're on the third watch. And you're sort of sat quietly. By this point, you're probably quite bored. Like the night's more or less silent. Like you hear the occasional scurrying of small animals in the darkness. Night birds call constantly. And then after a little while, you're sat. Can I get a perception check?
Seven.
Seven.
Six.
Oh,
yeah.
Six.
Six.
Sorry, backing up a quick second. Something I had wanted to do during my watch.
Okay, yeah.
Would be to try and communicate with one of the small animals.
Okay.
Around. So I don't know if I could find. Ideally, I'd want to find a woodpecker. But I don't know if I'm in that one.
Okay, what are you? You're You're the first one.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, we can go that. We can do that quickly. So, roll A. Are you going to venture away from the camp to try and find one?
No, I would wait for. I mean, it's a pretty big size. Like, if it, I don't need a woodpecker, I just like one.
Yeah.
Woodpecker noise.
Okay. I'd say that there's constantly birds around you, so you can make an attempt to try and communicate with one.
Because essentially, because I can communicate, like, simple ideas.
Yeah.
So I would want to communicate it with it, to stay here, and to, like, make a racket if it senses danger.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that. Roll a, it'd be like a charisma check to try and convince this bird, or animal handling, whichever's better for you.
Charisma check. 15 plus 1, 16.
16. Okay. Yeah. I'd say. So after a small while, just sat around. A bird lands on a branch near Bonnie, and it begins just watching you. You're not being seen. Sat down by into a cave. How do you? What does it look like when you're communicating with animals? How are you conveying these ideas to it? Is this something subtle like hand motions, or are you actually like whistling little bird calls to it?
Yeah, I'd say almost like whistling, so I'd like to call it over.
Okay.
And then like almost like a mixture of like bird calls and gestures to kind of communicate with it.
Okay. So
this woodpecker.
Yeah, bang it on against the I understand perfectly. So you sort of like whistle, like you point around and whistle a few more times, and yeah, you manage to convey to this bird, and it'll make some noise, for you if anything comes.
Sweet.
So I think it's probably what we cut to then, so run during your rest as you're sat there. You probably hear it, but you don't see anything. You just hear this bird starts making a bit of racket up above you. Your watch wouldn't have overrun with this, so would you have passed the message down the line that there was this bird watching over?
I told you about it.
Okay, so you're aware that this bird is supposed to be used as a alarm. This bird begins chirping and flapping its wings angrily, and then somewhere down, you can't really see where it is, down in the woods, you hear a scream. And it sounds like a male voice.
Uh-oh, them cultists!
I would at that point definitely come in like way too long.
Okay. Sweet.
What else up
next? I'm aroused. I'm aroused.
I'm not.
You guys are smelly.
I'd say Birdie has got his alarm and has a big scream. He said he was bored, so he might have been snoozing too. And I've heard a scream out there. Battle station.
Okay, roll, can everybody roll perception for me?
Me again?
Yeah, go for it. Can I have a second?
Maybe it's set.
14.
Maybe 10.
10.
9. So 14's the highest. Okay, I'd say you probably see a little bit more than Yala, not much. You squint out into the distance, and you can see it's a good way away. And it doesn't seem to be moving towards you. You can just see, you squint out through the darkness, and you can see what looks like a small flame in the distance, moving at quite some pace, sort of from left to right as you look out to the east, so moving north to south. I mean, you see it flip behind trees. It seems to flicker as it moves behind trees, and it's just moving from left to right. And then after a few seconds, you do hear another echoed scream as it continues weaving around in the distance.
Would I be able to roll to see if I know what it is? Like a nature check?
Yeah, you don't really need that. It just seems like somebody with a torch.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I guess I thought it was like his tail or something.
No, in this case it is. It does seem like it's a man with a torch.
Oh, okay.
I mean, the pace he's moving at, he's either chasing or, judging by the picture of his screen, he's running from something.
Sure.
Nope!
That's a terrible idea.
He's a good ways away. Like you've only just noticed. You can only just see it in the distance. But you can just tell by the movement of the flame that it seems to be somebody running.
Okay, group huddle. Do we want to get involved?
I quite like the but he might have stuff.
stuff.
We did well with the last thing.
He has fire.
We have two fire.
We've got
better fire.
Two fire is just as good as one.
Double fire, and what does it mean?
Two fires worked out pretty well for you so far.
That's true.
You might be right. There might be some bigger out there that we can kill again and have more things.
Triple fire!
Yes. One fire, two fire.
If we take his fire, yeah, three fire.
I shake my head. I had been joking when I said triple fire, but now you seem so serious about it.
I'm like,
Look, I just.
Yarla is so disappointed.
So we could go out and scout and see what's going on.
Or we could call out to him, get him to run this way, we hide and see what it is behind him.
What if it's done something deadly?
We just go, oh, no, actually, stop.
Well, no, we hide.
No, because then they'll run past and they'll keep following him.
That's a good idea.
So
like your
if
style.
If we don't like what we see, then we won't get involved. And it'll just run.
What could go wrong? Let's do it.
Okay, cool. So who's going to yell out to this guy?
Well, I guess it will.
Hello.
I'm good at that.
Okay, yeah. So Ding, what do you yell out into the forest? You can see he's sort of moving sort of diagonally towards you now. So as he moves through the forest, he's getting a little bit closer, but generally he's sort of moving perpendicularly to you.
You there!
Okay, yeah, you
come!
Okay, yeah, sweet. He doesn't need much convincing. You see he stops for a second. He's sort of at the foot of the hill that you're on now. And I'd say he's probably, let's say, 200 feet away. You can see he looks up, but I'm wondering if you'd be able to see the light from inside your cave. He looks up. You can see some light coming from your general direction where the opening to the cave is. So you do see he begins making a beeline up the, scrambling up the side of the hill. I'm slipping in the pine needles as he comes scrambling towards you. A few seconds later, how fast Dark Vision for you guys?
60.
And then
I would also have taken this opportunity to climb the nearest tree.
Okay,
almost
yeah.
Immediately.
So we see to get up to our height.
Yeah.
So is it like
no? How the fuck you?
Yeah, I'd say in the woods it is. Yeah.
So we can see 60 feet.
Mm. So yeah, I'd say he drops his torch at his side, and it thumps into the needles and immediately begins sort of. Casting an extra little bit of a fire, and as he begins scrambling on all fours up the slope towards where you are, and then a few seconds later, you see coming into the fire of this torch, stalking down low, is a tiger.
Oh,
hello.
Just a regular tiger.
Hello,
armor.
just a normal tiger. We're all good.
Mm-hmm.
We're all suddenly hungry and interested.
So it looks like the regular variety. He looks. In the brief second you see his face, he looks like he's beginning to see relief, but he mostly just looks tired. You can see that he's got scratches all up one side of his arm, where he's clearly been half mauled already.
Is he a human?
He is human. He's scrabbling up the slope towards you. I think the tiger's going to start catching up to him now.
Cool. I'm going to start laying it towards him.
Okay, cool. So we're going to say
battle stations. Then.
Battle stations. It's going to be very brief battle
stations.
One eight out. But battle stations nonetheless.
Ready for a stew.
My mate!
Ooh, 19.
Come on.
Initiative.
Nice.
20.
Oh,
I got
4.
17.
Dwarf first laying in, you two just sprint past.
He's the first one to go, he gets 5 yards.
And somehow I'm real nimble in the trees, fucking Tarzan leaving from branch to branch.
I just trip and I'm rolling down the hill.
Right,
Well, we'd be surprised if it opens the mouth and has giant fangs, and it's actually a saber tooth tiger.
Tiger's running away from something else.
2-0.
Nice.
All the reduced stuff.
Yarla
wears off.
Yarla, what initiative did you get?
What did I have? 18.
17. No.
17 and 30.
4. This poor sat on these guards.
Come on, buddy, you can do it!
Come on, boy!
You gotta find out where you've been. Find your corpse.
Where'd you go?
Tiger.
Yeah.
That's a beautiful, beautiful song.
No, it's that remix.
Where'd you come from, Tiger Guy?
Oh, it's not looking good for Tiger Guy. 8.
It's so fast.
And that's
faster than,
What is the eye of Tiger Guy? The thrill of the fight.
The thrill of the chase.
Running from the real tiger.
Holy
shit. And it's gonna fucking even better for me at best.
That's so lucky.
Okay, so I said he was about 200 feet away when he dropped his torch, so he'd be one turn closer to you, so...
How long is magic?
So he just disappeared into the darkness if we asked him a torch?
Yeah, basically. So yeah, he's 25 foot closer, so he'd be 175 feet away.
Magic missile's 120 feet away. Range.
And let's sort this out. So, Run, you're up first.
Alright, so I'm going to move up. Just, well, since we're all moving up, I'll move up 30 foot towards, and I will be behind the tree, and prepared to attack with my, fire breath. If, for example, the tiger comes within the 15 foot towards me.
Sure, I'm set.
I'm trying to, apart from that, apart from dodging.
Oh, that's not fair. Sorry, one sec. That's better. Right, so you move 20 foot closer.
Yeah, 30.
30 foot. So it's 30 foot closer. And then you're going to prepare a fire breath for if somebody just gets within range of your fire breath.
Yeah,
it's fine.
Can tell the difference.
Only the tiger.
I can tell the difference between human and orc. Mammal and tiger.
Won't you be surprised when he comes up and he's actually painted black and orange? He's like, I was trying to blend it. I get the torch.
Yarlet, you're up next.
Yep. I'll move up 25 feet.
Yep.
Kind of like hiding around a tree. And I'm gonna prepare a magic missile for the tiger.
Cool, that's
fine.
I can
nuke this thing.
What's the range on that?
120 feet.
120 feet, okay.
He's not even gonna get to us, is he?
Nope.
That's fine.
Pretty good.
Din, you're up.
I'm gonna be closer. 30, is that my speed?
Yeah, that's what it says on your sheet.
I'm getting my mace out.
Yeah.
Let's go stove this guy.
So
not, no, not the guy.
He just goes, oh, thank you for your help!
I say to Tiger, you're welcome, I say.
Come, join our meal! Sit by our fire! Just sweet. Cuts to all four of us eating the tiger like with all the time before.
It's the tiger's turn first, unfortunately, for this poor sap.
Run!
Come on, tiger guy! Run, tiger guy!
Tiger guy!
The new hit show on
ABC.
Tiger guy.
Tiger moves 40 foot a turn.
Oh no!
So it catches up straight up to him immediately. Where he's scrabbling up the slope, he just can't get any sort of grip. His feet are sliding as he's resorted to moving on all fours. But yeah, the tiger also moves into the darkness between the two of you. He moves at least 20 feet, which he does, towards a feature, then attacks with his claw.
His music is going well.
Yeah.
So, is it in range of me now?
He would now be, let's find out. So, he would be, one sec. So, 175, and then you move 25 foot. He'd be 150 feet away.
Ah, oh, so close!
Either way, he's got his torch, you would be able to see it.
True. Yeah. So, and then what did the tiger roll?
Not that well.
Oh, a 9. Lucky fucker. So there's some. Yeah, and he didn't hit, so he doesn't take the next effect. So yeah, you hear some scrambling in the darkness. You hear,
no.
But then there isn't a scream of pain that immediately follows.
Yeah.
That's how you like slips out of the slow.
And then next up is Well, it's this guy's turn, so he's going to disengage.
Run, Tiger Guy!
Tiger Guy!
Is he going to disengage, or is he just going to...
The hero truly deserved.
I think would he run 60 if he, what, would he raise full dash speed if he didn't disengage his rat?
That's his only hope he's got of actually getting away, or the tiger can catch him. So yeah, he's going to dash, and the tiger's going to take an opportunity attack.
Oh, don't worry, tiger.
Oops.
Yeah, it's also middle for it, don't worry.
So,
can you choose which... No!
Good.
If he can survive one hit, he can get away.
No.
Tiger God!
So, yeah, you hear some scrambling, and then they after his brief, you hear that. along with the sound of a sort of wet crunching.
No!
Yeah, his scream.
UK Tiger
Guy. Very heavily abbreviated.
I wanted to save him. Make him part of our group.
Then, Nuck, it's your turn.
Let's get him!
I dash towards him, 50 feet.
50 feet, okay, so that puts you.
I've done that.
Feet away.
You dash, don't you?
Yeah, you do actually. You double speed.
And then you can't do anything else. So then you're going to move.
Do you actually take an action?
I just moved nearer and got my mace out.
Yeah, so could Smith grip on that and dash?
If you want, to just be closer, then yeah, you can actually just use a double movement. So you can move even further because you've got more movement. You've got 30.
Almost 30, yeah.
So you move 60. One sec. So there you are.
We still must be about 100.
So this dude probably died like pretty close to you.
Six
powering close. So.
I'm close.
But I've got a hankering for a Steven. I've got a taste for it. Druid.
So then, what's your moving 50? So
yeah, because I've got 25 movement at the moment.
Yeah, it's fine, I'll level up. It's fine, let's see. Okay, cool. And then it's back round to Runster.
Do it, run!
So you hear some low volume, growling.
Some of us should shout, run at the guy.
Next time. So you're closer to the tiger now.
Yeah.
I would feel like it's you beside the view. I feel my 4 foot 30.
Okay.
And then once again over there.
See? Yep, that's
fine. Look at when you're gonna use it just
it's a fairy tale that you don't see what happens to him.
Yeah.
And it doesn't get the use there.
Yeah.
But,
So, Yarlet, you're up. What are you doing next?
I'll move 25 feet closer. Oh, hang on. Is there any driftwood around?
No.
No, like pieces of bark?
I wouldn't say just hanging around on the floor, no.
No, it's okay. I can't surf.
You want to Legolas down.
Yeah. It just as I pass up the.
So you want something suitable to... I'd say you're probably close enough to the edge of the gravel field that there'd be some slates. There'd probably be palm buried over stone or slate. If you wanted to jump and surf ball onto that, it would be acrobatics and it'd go horribly wrong for you.
I think good if your captain did die. Breaks his neck, trust.
But
I'm all for encouraging this sort of bullshit.
My deck's not that good. I'm more worried about surfing straight into the tank and not killing it immediately with magic missile. I'll wait for you guys to get to the closer. I will pick up one of the slates.
Okay, yeah.
And then move my 25 and then prepare to use magic missile.
Okay.
Closer.
That's fine. So actually, you need vision on it to be able to do magic missile. So you need line of sight to be able to. So you can on it.
So how far am I?
So let's figure out, let's do some maths now. So Yala, you move another 25. So
I'll just dash. I'll dash 50.
Okay, so that gets you up to 75 feet from where you started. The tiger is now 25 feet from where you started. So you would be 100 feet away from that.
Okay.
You don't know where it is, but
my target position is 60, right?
Yes, you can see it then. Sweet, so then, Dean, you're up.
Cool. I'm 150 feet away?
Yeah, you can, if you want to, you can divide up the movement. Well, like, dashing is basically using your action to move another 30 feet, so you want to use your movement to see where that gets you.
Yeah, I'll do that. I'll move 30 and see if I'm about to walk into it.
So yeah, so you move 30, so that's 90 feet from where you started. It's now 25 feet, so it'd be 65 feet from you, so you still wouldn't quite go to see. Is it 60 feet you've got?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's just outside of where you can see. Do you get dim vision for a little bit further, or is it
because
just...
you said that it's total darkness, so we're okay. Seeing as if it's dim light.
Right, okay.
The 85.
He's moved 25. Yeah, he's starting 200. He's moved 25. You've moved 19.
Yeah.
So is that 85?
Yeah.
I'll trust your maths.
Yeah, yeah.
So 85 feet away. Yeah, you did have your maths in there. But you can probably judge roughly how far away he is, judging by how fast the boat is. Actually, roll a perception check.
Just call that to him. Call him up. Hey, tiger.
You can't judge how far away he is. If you keep running down the hill, you might be able to see it. You know.
Maybe I should just stay put rather than charging ahead of everyone.
Okay. So you're gonna dodge, prepare an attack. What are you gonna do?
I'll put my fire breath.
Okay. So yeah. So if a tiger comes within range of your fire breath, you want to use it?
Yeah.
That's fine. So you're now 9 foot closer. Flame prepped. So now it's the tiger's turn. He's not going to do anything at the moment. He's quite contented where he is. He's not even really aware. Actually, let's see. You've come charging down the hill now. You hear Din, you in particular. You now hear growling coming from the darkness. Like, it goes from the sound of satisfied eating. So the sound of the flesh tearing stops, and you hear like a low rumbling growl. But it's not really close.
He's aware of us, though.
He's aware. Not really close. Does he have dark vision?
I can imagine so.
You should check that. Yes, he does 60 foot, so he can't see you, but you weren't making any attempts to be quiet, so he would have heard you getting that close. Who's up? Sorry, it would be the Sam's turn, but he's dead, so Nuck, you're up.
Yay! Dash,
okay.
All the way, so I think I'll be 10 foot in front of Smith now. Because he was 10 foot ahead of me, I run 50.
So you're running into 100 feet?
Yeah, and before me, I run 50.
So yeah, that's fine.
Can I see it, yeah?
It'd be 75 feet away from you, so. Okay, cool. That's fine. Run, it's round to you.
I guess I join the battle line because
we're fun. So you're gonna move at 4:30?
Yeah.
So yeah, you catch right up to where Din is.
Presumably.
No. I hear.
Yeah. And he can give you a general heading, although you can roughly tell where he is. Like the fire down at the bottom of the hill is slowly getting bigger. That's the point. How big is it going to be now?
Did you dash one go?
Yeah, at the end of this, the fire at this, you can't see him now.
Actually, he should be like, basically 2 turns behind us. He hasn't dashed once. I've dashed twice, but he's dashed once.
They should be 60.
Did you not dash?
No, so this time I should dash up.
Why did I have you 60 then? Okay, that's fine. So you'd be 60 foot, so you'd be 30 foot behind.
Yeah.
Oops, wrong one. I would say...
You're dashing now instead.
Yeah.
Oh, so you are dashing.
Yeah. I now dash.
Okay,
that's
sweet.
Fine.
That's fine. I'd say at the start, just at the start of your turn as well, I would say the tiger, as the fire at the bottom of the hill grows bigger, it's going up to the side of the campfire now, so it would cast up quite the tiger slowly comes into view. And you do see that there is a man face down at the pine needles,
Tiger guy!
Large hole opening in the small of his back.
Are you okay?
And yeah, the tiger is sort of stooped over him, like looking like a dog guarding its toy land or prey.
Fantastic. The tiger opened it up for him. This tiger guy was having trouble breathing.
Yeah.
That big hole.
It's too hot.
Yeah.
Gotta let the blood breathe.
Exactly.
The spine needs to breathe.
Well, no. So that's good.
Okay, sweet. That's fine. So, Yarlet, you're up. You can actually see this thing, but it's... where did you move to? 75, so...
Is it range?
What's the feet range on your...
120.
Is it range? If you walk forward, it would be in range.
Okay, so yeah, I will walk forward.
So you're going to move your full movement?
Yep.
So 25, so yeah, it's 100 foot. So, yeah, it's now 75 feet from you.
Great. Alright, and... No one's attacked him yet, right?
No, at the moment he's crouched over his kill, and it very much looks like he's just trying to ward the dragons away.
Should I fire?
Why not?
If you fire it, don't kill it, it'll come straight to you. Whereas it might scare it away.
Yeah, no, that's what I'm worried about. I'm worried about scaring it away. If I do too much damage on it, it tries to run.
You also don't want to burn it all up and get rid of all the leather.
Well, yeah, but magic missile would.
No.
Burn it. No.
Where's the fire?
Gonna have to stove it.
I'll try and nail it, so.
That's a different turn.
Thank you.
You're using efficiency and eating it.
Give yourself an inspiration. Yeah.
So just kind of take aim at it, and then be like, "Hey, dick!"
Fire. Yeah, you cock the thumb to fire magic missile. Cool.
Cool tiger.
I do the same thing for no reason.
So it's just rolling damage, isn't it?
Yep.
So roll it up.
4.
Why is there no save whatsoever?
No, you just roll damage. That's why it's so fucking OP.
Yep. 9 plus 3, 12.
No,
literally one of the best level 1 skills in the game.
Yeah, so what colour is it for you, Matt?
Purple.
Purple,
same
okay.
as my eyes.
Nice, so yeah, these purple streaks go hurtling through the darkness from your outstretched finger. They whip around the dragonborns. Like, they look like they're going to go straight to their backs, but as soon as they get back in, they just whip neatly around them and then return to their original course towards the tiger. They all sink in. They let out a large yell. And then it would be the Sam's turn, but he's dead. Nuck, you're up.
How far away am I from Tiger? Close to
death. You'd be 75 feet.
I'll get to it. It's a middle thing. Middle tree.
Yeah, but it's lower than the vulture was. The vulture died after.
I'm just going to dash it.
Do it!
Can I move up so that I am 45 feet away from it?
That would be 55 feet. Not 55. Because it's 75. So yeah, you can move.
If I move 25, I'm 50 feet away.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So I'll do that, and then I will prepare my force staff to bring it down on it.
Okay.
So basically, attack next.
Cool. Run. It's your turn. It's 25 and you're 90, so 35. It would be 10, 85 feet away. So let me think. So, yeah, if you do 60, you'd be well out in front. You'd be up.
Did I miss a go?
No, you're next. Oh, you'll do. Oh, actually, wait. It is Din's turn. Sorry, I have missed a turn. Yeah, it's Din's turn.
I'll go level with.
I skipped to that over Din. So what are you doing? You're moving.
I'm moving
full 30.
Full 30, okay.
Prepping my fire.
So you're 120 feet forward from where he started. Are you 80 feet from where he started? He's moved 25. So 80 minus 25. Is that 55? 55, you're 55 feet away now.
That's like that.
Cool. Yeah, that's right.
Well, that's not cool.
Now it's round to you, run.
Okay. Now that we've had that lovely conversation, I'm gonna walk into the forest and never see anyone. So now, yeah, like I said, I'm gonna get back up some wood.
Okay, so you're moving.
I don't know if we can move any further forward since I can't do any action, but I'll go up to the one side.
Okay, so yeah, so you'd be 120 feet from where you started right up next to the game. Cool, yeah, that's fine. And then you're just gonna have flame crack in case you need it, or
I can't come up because he's an
Oh, you dash? If you dashed, you would put yourself in front of him.
Oh, well, if I don't get that far, then you need more prepared to attack.
Okay, yeah, that's fine. So now it's, Jarl again.
Run away now. Yeah, probably does.
Jarl, you're up.
Oh, I am.
Yeah.
So it's not
one second, I'm trying to... Oh, I missed out. It's... I did skip the tiger's turn, yeah, sorry, so...
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah, the tiger, having been hit by the thing, he's actually going to make a strength check. Gonna have to move at half speed then. What's his speed? 40. Okay, so he grabs the ankle of Tiger Guy and drags him 20 feet in the opposite direction.
Oh, this little bit shit!
No! So yeah, he's gonna move 20 feet in the opposite direction, so he's back up to 195 feet from where you guys started.
Alright, I'm gonna run 25 feet closer.
Let me make sure I'm in the right order now.
I have two spells on, so I can use them two times.
Whatever
you short rest,
I get one. Oh no, I've lost track of the turn.
So
Tiger went.
So you're
short at it. And
it.
That's where Tiger went. And Nuck, we skipped that one, didn't we? So. Lost track of the turn. Who just went? So before that, the previous turn, it was you, wasn't it? So yeah, it is Yala. Sorry,
okay.
It's your turn.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, I'm moving 25 feet closer. I'm gonna nail it again.
Okay, sweet. Yeah, that's fine. So you're up to
leave Tiger Guy alone.
He did nothing to you.
Let her rip
like a fucking Beyblade. Here we go.
Other hand this time.
Four.
Three.
Two.
So that's 9, 12 again. So this thing's taking 24 damage so far. Come on, die!
Okay, so now it's still going. You can see it quite clearly. It's dragged the guy back.
Does it look pretty hurt though?
It does now. It's starting to look pretty torn up now. Like, it's got these welts all over its body where the magic missiles hit it. I mean, you can see patches that are scorched and then left furthers. But no, it's still moving. So after y'all, it's round to you, Din.
Charge.
You're gonna sprint, or are you gonna? You would be. It's 5 feet from where it started. So you're 200 feet away. And if you run, you'll be 45 feet from it. If you sprint, you'll be that minus 30, so you'll be 50 feet from it.
That's pretty good. Do it. Charge it.
Should I? Yeah. Charge it.
Okay. Sweet.
Fuck it. I'm assuming you nearly covered it.
16. So you're 15 feet, so... Yeah, you're 15 feet from it. You could probably throw your mace from there if you wanted to. That's fine.
Mace just destroy over 10.
Just hits Tiger Guy in the face.
That's nice.
You were surviving on 1 HP until that
turn. Returning to normal turn order, it's the tiger's turn. This kill isn't worth it, it's gonna die. So yeah, it's just gonna sprint in the opposite direction now.
Fucker!
And that second hit took it down too low. Can't take another one of those. So,
I might still be in range on it though.
So it moves 80 feet.
I've got fireball.
It just moved 80 feet away. 80 feet away. Jesus.
I thought it was hurt.
Plus 80. So yeah, it's miles away. So yeah, it moves 80 feet in the opposite direction. It just disappears off into the darkness.
Oh, now we're gonna have to eat Toe Guy.
So Nuck, it would be your turn.
How far away is the guy? How far away is the tiger?
He left him, so he dragged him 20 feet. So he would be five foot from the point where they started, which is
so basically I was 50 foot away. If I dash, then I'll still be 20 foot away.
So yeah, he left him at what would have been 25 feet away. So he'd be
I'm just gonna use all of my movement.
It's 195. You used all of your movement. What's all of your movement?
50.
So if you said you'd be 25 feet from the body. 170.
At least we'll get some experience for it.
Yeah. So you'd be at 170 feet from where you started. He's at 195, so you're 25 feet away. Cool. And then it is back to you.
I mean, it's gone now, isn't it?
For all intents and purposes, let's have a look. Yeah, I would say at this point, with it being Batman to you, the tiger is now gone.
Not even if I surf after it?
No, I'd say because it's also 80 feet into the darkness.
Okay,
it's disappeared from you, so you just.
No, I should have surfed!
I was too scared.
That's it. Heading straight over to Tiger Guy to see if he's dead or just unconscious.
Okay. Yeah, he's all planted dead.
Look,
I stove his face in.
Damn you! Why couldn't you stay alive?
Pure frustration.
We high five.
Okay.
Cool. What we're aiming to do, right?
Yeah. So, I think this is going to be where we finish.
Whooping around dead tiger guy.
Yeah,
we're
pretty much on the time. So I think this is the sort of closing shot is Nuck moving down the hill to where this guy's laying face down. You're quite well illuminated now, so this small forest fire is spread quite rapidly. You take a second, like you see this fire is spreading rapidly in front of you. It's probably something you can do with it, but your eye gets distracted when you get closer to tiger guy. As you look down, you can see that around his waist there's lots of bottles tied around. As you yank one off his belt and pull the cork out and you lift it to your nose, and the credits instantly light. Yeah, the credit screen appears right after you see a huge grin appear on the wall's face.
Say, well, tiger guy.
Sweet, and I think that's where we close it.
Alright.
See.
Good session. Should I leave my thing here?
Yeah, leave it all here.